In this shoemaking tutorial, we're gonna talk about shoe soles. There are many different types of shoe soles, and in this tutorial, I will talk about main types of shoe soles constructions made from leather. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and make sure to click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. So let's start. Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses. To create a shoe sole made from leather, it's not an easy task. So, to make it easier for beginners and all my students, I created a little bit different approach of shoe sole making made from leather. Using this approach, you will create your shoe soles with minimum tools and very easy and fast.
Here will be the line of the outsole. Close the line on the outsole. Walk the line on each of the outsole with the rim. Okay. When you feel that you made your job and your edge is very smooth, you can on to the next.
So how to build this type of shoe soles made from leather? First thing that you need to create is the pattern for the shoe sole. And pattern you can make only after you will last your upper on the shoe last. And then after you will last it, you will cover your flattened bottom of the shoe last with masking tape and make the pattern. To create exact pattern of the shoe sole, you will need to flatten the shoe bottom with cork and sand the entire bottom with rasp or sanding machine if you have, or Dremel. So after you will have this precise pattern, you will cut it from leather. Then you need to scuff the edges of the leather because you will work with too thick leather. I told it about different parts of vegetable tan leather needed to create shoe soles, and for shoe soles we use the sole bands. So this part of the height is thick, and for women's shoes we need to scuff edges of the shoe sole to have very elegant and nice edge of the shoe soles. So after you will scuff it, you will have thin edges and it will look great on your shoes. And before you will attach this already cut and scuffed shoe soles, you will need to work on the edge of the shoe sole. You will need to finish this edge, because after you will attach it, it will be very difficult to create beautiful finishing of the edge. And you want to have beautiful shoe sole, right? So after you will finish this edge, you can attach your ready shoe soles to the bottom of your shoes. So this is how it looks. You see, we have here cork that cover almost entire middle part of our shoe bottom. We sanded here edges and we have precise line of the shoe sole. Then when you will cut your shoe soles, will finish the edge, you will have this kind of shoe sole. Then you can attach it to the shoe bottom. And then after you attach it, you can create here heels by yourself or attach ready-made heels. You see, here comes here heel. Exists another way of shoe sole, to create shoe sole, where shoe sole covers the entire bottom of the shoes, and only then on this part of your shoe sole you will build your heels. So this is was first type of shoe sole making that I created especially for my students. So you, as a total beginners, will be able to create beautiful and comfortable shoe soles that will look professionally. Second type of cemented shoe sole making is very similar to the first one, but it requires a little bit experience in shoemaking. Why? Because to create second type of shoesole, you will need to have this special knife, lip knife. So what is this construction is about? You will need to create a little bit bigger shoesole in the way where the edges of this shoesole will extend from the upper. And after you will attach this scythed shoesole, you will cut extra of the shoesole working with this special knife. Although it has this kind of protection to not cut your upper, not scratch your upper, it will be very difficult to cut this extra of the shoesole at the first time. After you will cut extra of the shoesole, you will need to finish the edge of the shoesole using special irons or special tools that you can prepare by yourself. And in my courses, I explain how to do it and finish this shoesole edge to have beautiful and shiny edge. And that's why I created first type of shoesole making, where you don't need to have a special knife, where you don't need to have any shoemaking skills. These two types of shoesoles are good for casual shoes, for sandals, for flats, for pumps. But there is another third type of shoesole that is good only with these types of heels. You see, this type of heels where we have here this straight edge, and we need to cover it with shoesole. So shoesole will cover the entire shoe bottom and this part of our heel.
Only on the edges, but also we'll sky all this part attached
to the heel. So this part of our shoesole must be very thin, and to create this type of shoesole you can use first way of shoesole making, where you will have exact shoesole pattern including this part of the heel, and then after you will attach this heel to lasted shoe, you will attach your already finished shoesole, and you will attach it also on this part of our heel. You see, now it is difficult without the shoe last, but to demonstrate it, it's enough. So this approach of shoesole making is good only when you work with this type of heels. It can be high heels like this one or low heels. Okay, so if you work with these heels, use this approach. Now let's talk about two other shoesole constructions where you will need to have a little bit experience in shoemaking, because you will need to know how to sew these shoesoles to the shoe upper. First one is the Apanka shoesole. Is one of the most beautiful shoesole construction in my opinion. This shoesole you will need to sew by hand on your upper. This type of shoesole overlap the edge of the shoe last, and then this edge you will sew by hand to the upper. You will sew it through upper and lining.
Enter the owl parallel to yourself and make.
What is special about this shoesole construction? To create this Apanka shoesole, you almost don't need to work with glue, because you sew this shoesole, as I said before, to the upper end lining by hand. So how to create this type of the shoe sole? You also will need to create first the pattern of the shoe sole, and you can do it only after you will last your shoes, last your upper and lining, and you will have already lasted shoe. And then you will need to create pattern of your shoe sole that will include only the edge of the shoe sole. After you have this pattern, you can enlarge it on 8 millimeters or 1.2 centimeters to have this kind of edge that overlap the shoe, okay? And you can decide what kind of edge you want to create, high or low, okay? And working with this pattern, you will add this extra around your pattern and you will have the pattern to create shoe sole apanka. You will need to skive the edge of this shoe sole. After you will skive it, you can attach a little bit only in the middle to fix it on the right place, this shoe sole, and then working with the awl, you will sew it and will have this beautiful shoe sole construction. The last shoe sole construction that you can use working with leather is welted shoe sole construction. This construction is one of the most complicated shoe sole types because it requires a little bit experience in shoemaking. And I teach how to create this welted construction in my bespoke English Oxford shoes, this one. It's actually good for men's shoes as well as for women's shoes, like this.
And to push it as much as you can and stretch at the same time.
So how to create this type of shoe sole? First step is the insole making from leather. In this step, you will need to prepare your insole to the next steps of the work. You will need to create the holdfast. The holdfast is the curve around the insole that includes holes. Through these holes, you will sew the upper and weld together. So, after you will last the upper on the insole, you will need to prepare the weld. This is the strap of leather that you will sew to the insole and upper through the holes in the holdfast. After you will create this kind of work, you will move on to create the shoe sole. Next step is to prepare the shoe sole. You will use the entire width of your shoe sole because here we don't need to skive, we need to have this thickness, 4-5 millimeters. You will cut a little bit bigger piece of leather, and then after you will attach it to the bottom of the shoe sole, to the weld, to the bottom, you will cut extra of this shoe sole and finish the edge together with the weld. Then you will sew the shoe sole to the weld. After you will sew the shoe sole to the weld, you will need to finish the edge, and at the end it will look like one solid shoe sole, but it actually consists of two layers, weld and shoe sole. And here you see the stitches. This construction is solid and strong because here we have double stitches. And this type of shoe sole are good for men's shoes, of course, but it's good as well for women's shoes. Now you have learned about five most common shoe sole constructions where you can create shoe soles working with leather. The main goal of this tutorial is to make you understand that your possibilities are unlimited. You can create different shoe sole constructions like this one and use it in any footwear types. For example, you can create flats with welted construction. You can create sneakers with a panka shoe sole. You can create sandals also with different construction. So it depends on your taste, on your shoe design. And this is what I teach my students because I want that you, like my students, will have this knowledge and know how to create many different shoe designs. That's it. If you have questions, please comment below this video. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you still are not my subscriber, and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye!